Hello and welcome to the Sisters of Battle painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to paint the cream armour and the red and black robes of the Order of the Thorn. Now, before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. As you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey, which is a nice undercoat for all the varied tones we're going to be applying in this video. Now, I'm going to start first with the cream armour, and for this, we'll be using a base coat of Morgas Bone. So what I'm going to do is just grab myself a medium layer brush, apply a couple of dabs to my palette, a little bit of water, and then, as we always like to do, get a good point to our brush, and then we're ready to start base coating. Now you might want to do a couple of thin coats of this, because some of that grey will start to show through. So just take your time and just build up those layers. There we are, that cream armour now base coated. What we're going to do now is move on to the rest of the colours for the cream armour. We're going to start first with Skeleton Horde, which we'll thin down with some contrast medium. After that, once it's dry, we'll just relay those raised edges with Morgas Bone again. And then to finish off, we're going to do a highlight of Screaming Skull. But first of all, let's start with our contrast medium mix. So what I'm going to do is get about 3 dollops of contrast medium. And then I'm going to give it a quick wash. I'm going to get 1 dollop, nice technical term there. Just mix it together so it's a little bit thinner, not super neat like it is straight from the pot. And all I'm going to now do is just start coating that all over the bone armour. It'll settle quite nicely in the recesses. Won't change the tone of it too radically. You'll get some nice definition. There we are, that contrast now dry. What we'll now do is just relay some of those raised edges using Morgas Bone again. Just to add a bit more punch and definition to that bone. There we are, those raised details relayered now with Morgas Bone. We're going to finish off by highlighting with Screaming Skull. So where possible, I'm just going to use the edge of the brush for a nice consistent line. In some places, you'll need to use the tip. When doing that, just hold your breath and take your time. There we are, those highlights now done to the cream armour. We're now going to move on to the robes. We'll be using Black Templar first of all for all the black robed areas as well as any leather details. Galvorbat Red for the red robes. Then we'll be using Basilicanum Grey to coat over Galvorbat Red. Then we'll be highlighting the black robes using Dawnstone. And then we'll be highlighting the red robes using Corn Red followed by Evil Sun Scarlet. But first of all, let's start with coating in Black Templar. So I'm going to be using my medium layer brush here. So I'm just going to coat some of this onto the actual palette. This is not to thin down. I'm just going to make sure I get a decent point to my brush. And then all I'm going to do is find the interior of the robes. So that's all the underneath parts. I'm also going to coat like the basque and the gloves as well and any other leather details you want. There we are, I've all those details now picked out with Black Templar. What we're going to now do is start painting the red robed areas with Galvorbat Red. Again, with this particular paint, you might just want to do a couple of coats, just get a nice coverage over that grey. There we are, with Galvorbat now dry, we're just going to coat over the robes using Basilicanum Grey. You can just try and keep it to some of those recesses, but in some places you might need to tidy back up using Galvorbat Red. Now that the contrast is dry on those red robes, we're going to start highlighting the black. Now for this we'll be using Dawnstone. And the great thing of using Black Templar over Mechanica Standard Grey, you'll get yourself a bit of a highlight anyway, so jumping to Dawnstone isn't too much of a jump. There we are, with that black now highlighted, what we're going to now do is move on to highlighting the red. And for this we're going to start with Corn Red. And take your time, build on those edges, picking out those folds. If you do make any mistakes, just use Galvorbat Red to tidy back up. And there we are, that first highlight now done. What we're now going to do is finish off the red by using a little bit of Evil Sun Scarlet. Just give it a little bit more definition and also a nice bit of gradient as well. There we are, with the highlight now done. The almond robes of the Order of the Thorn is now completed. And remember, just by following the methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily apply this to any other unit in your Sisters of Battle collection. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own armour and robes of the Order of the Thorn. And we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.